I'm here with Mitch and Dakoda to talk about whatever that thing is.
So right here we have a 3D printer. This is a Voron, or what a 3D printer is additive manufacturing. So you can print parts by melting down filament plastic and extruding it at the shape you prefer. So this is more of an advanced printer than the ones around. We're building this for speed and efficiency, and so we can also print many parts out at a lower time frame. This allows us to print a higher quantity of parts with little interaction, giving us more parts within the smaller frame of time.
So essentially, the machine can run autonomously. We give it the work, and it does everything that we tell it to. So I would say the most difficult part would be that, you know, everything that you see right here, it was put together piece by piece. So when we got it, it came in a box. And, you know, even I would say the most difficult part would be adding the conveyor belt, because that's still kind of in the developmental phase, as you will. And, you know, there's not a lot of documentation on it. So, you know, we had to be creative and do a lot of trial and error to get everything working the way we wanted it to. But, you know, I can't be happier with the way it's turning out. So it's funny how this all started. Last year during J-term, I saw the Voron project, which it's an open source project, which means all the information is online. So everybody can build off of each other. And what that does is it, you know, it grows technology a lot faster than like closed source. And so when I saw this project, you know, just on a whim, I told Dr. Beer, I'm like, hey, we need this. What are the odds we can do this? And come to find out, he was in the market for a 3D printer for our floodplain modeling project, and, you know, just kept running with it. And that's how I got inspired to do it.
We definitely also saw a need, I feel like, within the engineering department, because of the other printers we've had with the high quantity prints we needed. We definitely needed a step up from these lower quality printers.
There's a lot of 3D printed parts on here, which is nice, because if you break a part, you can just print another one and you're good to go. You don't have to really buy it. But all the plastic parts, I would upgrade them to CNC aluminum. It just gives it more rigidity, it's stronger, higher temperature resistance, and then bling it out with a little more carbon fiber, which we have a carbon fiber rail that's coming for this, which is gonna increase the speed. With a growing engineering department, this allows us to print around the clock. So 24/7, you don't need really any human interaction when it comes to running this machine. It's all autonomous. So it's gonna allow students to design more complex projects and not have to worry about, am I biting off more than I can chew? Because we can produce it.
I also think the 3D printing here in the department in general is a great way for students to get hands-on experience and work with 3D CAD and printing, and kind of go through the design process and stuff without just sitting in a classroom. You get that hands-on experience.
And this is the technology of the future.